behold the unbelievable presence that is the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant.
The true meaning of a larger-than-life superstar.
The following contest is a triple threat tag team match. Introducing first, from Grenoble, France, weighing in at 520 pounds, the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant.
The tail of the tape, 7'4", 520 pounds, neck 24 inches, chest 71, biceps 21, hands 16, wrists 11, forearms 17, thighs 36, and calves 22 inches.
It doesn't matter what generation, what era, there is only one Andre the Giant.
Hulkamania has arrived.
The WWE Universe is on its feet.
And from Venice Beach, California, weighing in at 303 pounds, the immortal Hogan.
From music videos to Saturday morning cartoons, Hulkamania is everywhere.
Including this announce table. Try to be a little unbiased, Saxton.
WWE Universe on its feet for the immortal Hulk Hogan.
And Michael, you can see exactly why Hulkamania will never die.
Austin marching to the ring. The trademark scowl on his face, ready for business.
A man who just oozes attitude and does whatever he wants.
From Victoria, Texas, weighing in at 252 pounds, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Oh, the Texas Rattlesnake coming in hot from the Broken Skull Ranch.
WrestleMania 38 showed the Rattlesnake's fangs are still sharp.
And no matter how bad you may think you are, you should never mess with Stone Cold Steve Austin.
We are about to see something good.
And representing D-Generation X, from San Antonio, Texas, weighing in at 227 pounds, one half of the NXT Tag Team Champions, Shawn Michaels.
Matches like these, with talent of this caliber, this is why sports entertainment is an art form.
Doesn't matter the situation, the champion always has a winning game plan.
Get ready for the entrance of the big dog.
I really miss Cole doing that, Saxton.
I think I'd do it better.
I think it was subpar at best.
And from Pensacola, Florida, weighing in at 265 pounds, Roman Reigns!
Well, here is the merciless leader of the Bloodline.
Yeah, you can make the argument that the Bloodline is perhaps the most dominant group in the history of WWE.
I think you're right, Saxton. Roman put his entire family on his back and has since pushed them all to incredible heights.
He's achieved things that most only dream of. Just piles of championships.
Made the long climb up the mountain and shoved everybody else off of it.
One of the most dominating superstars of recent era.
You can go ahead and say it, Cole, of all time.
Quite simply, the greatest of all time, John Cena.
And from West Newbury, Massachusetts, weighing in at 251 pounds, John Cena!
No doubt about it, the absolute greatest of all time.
Yeah, nobody has been on top longer, and nobody has changed the game more.
You can't debate Cena's achievements, but you have to wonder, has Hollywood softened Big Match John?
Multiple teams in this match being fought under elimination rules.
Cutting the ring in half is going to be very difficult when you have more than one team to deal with.
Now, things won't become traditional until we're down to just two teams.
Got him set up in the corner of the ring.
Gentlemen, this is what I believe we refer to as unloading.
Set him up for the...
He was elusive there.
Reversal! Can he take it?
To the two count.
Quick shoulder up. How on earth could he not keep him?
He's lost some of his win now. Situational awareness with a knee in the action.
And dropping bombs.
He catches Cena with a counter.
Awesome coil and ready to strike.
Oh, impressive counter.
Stretching and tearing at all the ligaments in the leg.
And he gets delivered back in.
Stone cold stunner. This one is all but over.
He's out at two.
This is amazing.
Gets him with the counter.
Up and down with a jarring back suplex and a leg drop for good measure. For these
he may get the three count right here.
This is it.
The cover.
No, it's not.
I understand the sentiment, but now is not the time to bask in disbelief.
Bang! Vicious boot. Shoulders down.
And the count doesn't even begin.
What is it going to take? The
what a shot.
Austin. He's tied up.
Blockbuster!
No clue what he hopes to find down there.
The table. The WWE Universe is going wild.
Intercontinental by hand. Does he have it here?
You've got to be kidding me.
You are not alone in your shock, Cole. We all thought that was it.
The big dog. Unusual spot here.
Will Stone Cold end this?
Side headlock applied.
Oh, good measure.
Austin getting ready. From the top. Oh, the high risk doesn't pay off.
Taking a chance and it didn't pay off.
Shaking my head in disbelief over how he managed to get the shoulder up.
Big shot block. That'll stop me in your tracks. Turning the tables. Oh, look at this neck lock. Into a nice takedown. Will it be? Instantly, he has his shoulders up.
Are you kidding me? Not even a one count.
And that cuts Cena right off. Drops the hammer
right on the lower back.
Just punched him right in the mouth. Relentless. Right in the face. My God.
For the win.
There's two. That's it.
Cena's just going to have to eliminate.
He's doing some dangerous redecorating.
I think the table really ties it all together. And he gets set back into the ring. We got a little tandem offense in our future. And that was an efficient form of offense with that move. Oh, an inverted atomic drop. Very nice. They're setting the table on fire.
Oh, my God.
Off the turnbuckles.
What's he going to do?
Oh, target acquired and destroyed.
With the counter. Toss back into the ring. He may get the three count right here.
I don't think so. And they get the win. Outlasted every other team tonight.
Well, tag team matches are one thing, but make it three on three, and it's three times as good. Take a look.
Here are your winners, Sean Michaels, and Steve Austin.
And Steve Austin is the one to put this one away for the team.
Absolutely, Cole. We just witnessed quite the combination of endurance, in-ring savvy, and if I'm being honest, some pure luck.
Elimination matches are no picnic, but they still made it through in one piece.